Hey, what's going on everybody? Welcome back to another video. So today we're going to be doing an unboxing and review of the Zhiyun Weebill S. So just to let you guys know, Zhiyun actually sent this Weebill S out to me completely for free, but they didn't pay me to say anything positive about it. So I believe the launch price of the Weebill S was actually around $400 when it came out. But right now if you do go on Amazon, it's actually only $340, which is a pretty good price point for what this actually is. And of course I haven't even unboxed or reviewed it yet, but once I do, by the end of this video, I'll tell you guys everything you need to know about the Weebill S, and if it's really worth your $340. And to first take a look at the actual box itself, we just have the gimbal right here, and we have the name Weebill S, the name of the gimbal, and honestly has a really nice clean packaging to it, which actually kind of reminds me of some type of Apple packaging. And taking a look at the right of the box, we just have the Weebill S title right there, and on the back we have the gimbal in another position with the title here again, and on the left side of the box we just have the logo, and that's pretty much it for how the box looked itself. So after unwrapping everything, the first thing that we get here is this little booklet that you could open up. And inside that we have a quick start guide and a little service card with an awesome little graphic right there. And the next thing that we get is this paper with a bunch of accessories on it that you could pick up that didn't actually come with the Weebill S itself. Lastly, we finally just get the gimbal stuff, which is all enclosed in this styrofoam case. But something that I've actually seen from other YouTubers is that they're pretty upset that this doesn't have a handle that you could bring anywhere, which is actually kind of a problem, but we'll get into that later once we're actually doing the review. Looking into the carrying case, we can first see we get the camera riser in case you want to make your camera a bit taller when placing it on the gimbal. Next, we get a quick release plate that has a screw for your lens that we could take a look at later. Inside the small box with the USB logo on it, we get three camera screws that are 1/4 inch screws, micro USB to mini USB cable, micro USB to multi USB cable, micro USB to USB type C cable, micro USB to micro USB cable, and a simple USB to USB type C cable to charge the batteries for the gimbal. And speaking of charging, we get two 2600 milliamp hour batteries that go in the charger, which can be used with the USB type C cable that I just showed you. Here we have the tripod attachment that you can put on two parts of the gimbal to make it work in different ways. And finally, we have the gimbal itself, which is actually surprisingly really small. So that's pretty much it for the unboxing portion of the Zhiyun Weebill S, but I'm gonna use it for the next few days, and then we're gonna get on to the review portion, which I'm sure that a lot of you guys wanna know about. All right, so it's been about a week of testing out the Weebill S, and I'm here to share my experiences about it, including the pros and cons. Since I've never really used a gimbal before, this was entirely a new experience for me, including the balancing process. I was pretty confused at first on how to actually balance the gimbal, but I followed a really good YouTube video on it, which I'll actually link down below, and now even as a new gimbal user, I could probably balance it in under a minute. Zhiyun actually updated the design of this gimbal so that if you're using a larger camera and a large lens setup, you don't actually have to take off the eyepiece when trying to balance it. A feature that I found really helpful after balancing the camera is to go into the menu setting and click on the auto-tune function, and this is going to be able to match the best settings for the camera that you're using. With most gimbals, even the slightest weight change would completely unbalance your gimbal, but with the Weebill S, even if you decide to zoom in or zoom out with your lens, which kind of does just rearrange the weight balance, the Weebill S is actually going to balance this and compensate it by using their motor strength, but this will drain your batteries a little bit quicker. Now to talk about ergonomics, this Weebill S is actually really comfortable to use. It actually has a unique sling mode, which you can change by taking the tripod grip from the bottom and moving it over to the top. The gimbal itself is actually super compact, which can fit in a piece of A4 paper as they advertise. This can help in traveling a lot from shoot to shoot or wherever you're going, since you could just put the gimbal in the water bottle holder of your backpack, or you can just put it inside and it won't take up much space at all. The relatively light weight of this gimbal at only 926 grams is actually pretty easy on your arm, since if you're recording for a long period of time, a lot of gimbals for cameras of this size can actually put a lot of pressure on your arms, but for the Weebill S, it actually stays at a pretty good weight that helps you out a lot. But speaking of weight, as small as this gimbal is, it can actually support up to a 6.6 pound payload. For me personally, right now, I only needed it to support my Sony A6400, which is pretty easy for this Weebill S. However, looking into the future, I definitely want to upgrade to a Sony A7 III or another full frame camera with 4K, so this gimbal is honestly going to be really great for that and any camera that I really decide to pick up in the future. An issue that a lot of gimbal users have when they're not actually shooting but just transporting their gimbal from shoot to shoot is that the axes on their gimbal tend to swing around a lot. Zhiyun actually implemented a pretty creative solution to this with their axis lock, which can actually help you in balancing your gimbal and also when carrying it around at a shoot. When taking a look at the gimbal, we can also see that they included a 2-in-1 quick release plate, which allows for a quick setup and fast transitions between your equipment without having to rebalance. Even though Sony cameras, like the one that I'm shooting on right now, the Sony A6400, have incredible autofocus, some filmmakers also do want to pull their own focus, which this gimbal actually provides. All you'll need is the included cable that came in the box of your Weebill S, and also a servo motor. Zhiyun also introduced many new and improved accessories with the release of this gimbal, such as the transmount image transmission module, which is really helpful for features like HD image transmitting to your smartphone, Smart Follow 2 for object tracking, and sync motion, which allows you to control the gimbal with your phone. I unfortunately don't actually have the module with me right now, but if you guys are interested in learning more about these features, I'll link a great video down below talking about them, as well as a video on how to balance your Weebill S. A new feature in the Weebill S is actually their upgraded algorithm, which can help reduce a lot of the jitters that you get when recording your videos. I recorded some different scenarios with the Weebill S to show you guys how it holds up in different environments and different speeds. In my opinion, all those clips were really smooth and gave it a really professional look. None of these clips had any post stabilization on them, but honestly, if I was to add any type of warp stabilizer on Premiere Pro, I'm sure that these clips would look even better. Overall, from running full speed outdoors to being at home recording a tech product on my desk, the Weebill S actually handled every situation pretty well. Now to talk about some of the cons of the Weebill S, we could first start at the carrying case itself. For a relatively expensive piece of tech, Zhiyun should have really included a lock on the carrying case, as well as some extra protection. Besides that, I also found that the Weebill S had some random vibrations on it, which actually people around me could hear when I was recording with it. I'm pretty sure that this issue actually came from me just not balancing it properly, but after a few uses, it actually completely went away. Overall, for anybody using an APS-C or a full-frame camera, I really do think that the Weebill S is a fantastic gimbal. With an ergonomic design, strong motors for smooth footage, and a bunch of useful features that aren't just there to look good on a feature list, I definitely do think that the $340 is definitely worth your money for this gimbal. Anyways, thank you all for watching today's video. If you guys did enjoy this one, be sure to go down below and hit that like and subscribe button. And thank you again for watching today's video, and I'll see you all in the next one.